Hello and welcome to Sheffield Sharks TV. I'm Joshua Hagan. Tonight, the Sheffield Sharks take on the Leicester Riders, who have proven to be a big threat against the Sharks this season, remaining undefeated throughout. In this very tense playoff game, can the Sharks pull a win? Let's go to our analyst to find out. I'm here with Andrew Bridge tonight. He's our analyst. Andrew, can you just explain to the people who are new to basketball what the playoffs mean for the Sharks?
So the playoffs, it's a brand new competition, so it's the first round today. We're going to start in the quarterfinals. It's the top eight teams in the league get in, and the team that finished first will play the team that finished eighth. Second versus seventh, which is what we have tonight. So Leicester finished second, Sheffield finished seventh. The team that's the highest seed gets to choose whether they play at home or away first. Leicester obviously wanted to play at home second, which is why we're here on a Wednesday. It's a bit different for us. It's an exciting competition, fresh start for everyone. Although it's seeded, I really do think the top seven teams are all in with a chance of getting to the final at the O2.
The Sharks find Leicester pretty difficult this season. We've lost every match we've encountered them in. But the last one, it was only by 6 points. So what do you think the Sharks have to do to nail a win here today?
So the most important thing for Sheffield is to take care of the ball. So Leicester, a team that likes to play a pressing game, up-tempo. If Sheffield turn the ball over, that's going to play into Leicester's hands. They'll be able to come back for easy scores. But I don't really think it's going to have too much impact, Sheffield having lost every game. A couple of seasons ago, we lost to them four times. Then the fifth time, we played them in the trophy final and beat them. So that really, you know, I don't think it's going to factor in. It's a fresh start for both teams. Both teams are just going to be eager to come out and put themselves in a position to win on Friday. The interesting thing about this is basketball's not really a two-leg sport, but for this time, it is. Neither team can win the game tonight, so they just need to put themselves in a position where they can't lose it on Friday, and that's what both teams are going to be looking to do. Sheffield, I think if they come out with an 8 to 10 point lead, that'd be a good position for them to be in going down to Leicester on Friday.
Great, thanks Andrew. And let's go to our commentators, John Timms and Andrew Bridge, as the Sharks take on the Leicester Riders for the first game of the playoffs this season.
Thank you, Josh, and here we are at EIS Sheffield in the first round of the playoffs for the Sharks versus the Leicester Riders. It's a quarter-final matchup over two legs. And Andrew, what's the teams playing in these two-leg games? What's the most important thing to happen from tonight's game?
So it's a two-leg basketball game, not something, you know, that both teams play a lot of. But I think for both teams, you can't win the game in this first tie, or you can't win the tie in this first game, so you got to put yourselves in a position to have a chance to win, which for these guys will be on Friday. So for Sheffield, I think they're going to be looking to come out of the game with, you know, 8 to 10 point lead. If it's around there, Leicester will probably feel pretty comfortable with that too, obviously going to try and win, but that would set us up for a great game on Friday.
So a great game on Friday, we want to make sure we get to, and so far in this game two scrappy turnovers, but nobody's scored. Coming up to a minute gone here in the first as Mike Cook pushes back, creates some space, takes a shot and it doesn't quite drop, and the Riders pull the ball in, and the Sharks putting some early full court pressure on.
Yeah, something Leicester traditionally like to do, so look for definitely after free throws for Leicester to press, possibly made baskets depending on the situation in the game.
So great drive there from the Riders, gets to the basket, and Hassan Shad there gets the layup in, and it's 2-0 to the Riders. Straight away you can feel the intensity tonight in this basketball game, and Zyka Shade goes down the middle and lays it in.
So that's what Sheffield needed, you know, scrappy turnover and a step back three-pointer under pressure. Good decision by Gachet to attack the basket and got a relatively easy layup.
Mike Tuck there jumps out, makes Bernardini go the long way around, and Watson from the corner doesn't get a shot to drop, and Mike Cook tips it back in, and Riders player comes over the top and just pushes it out of bounds, and the Sharks get the ball.
Yeah, so here we go, Leicester full court pressure, really looking to make BJ and Mike Cook work, bringing the ball up. You know, Leicester obviously feel they have an advantage there. Another eat.
Mike Cook there just stepped through the gap, made everything look so easy.
Yeah, and I'm going to assume he was so wide open he didn't believe it and missed.
Watson there just sends the fake and left open and hits the three. Riders leading 5-2. But so far in this game, both teams making good things happen. Just waiting for the game to settle down. Oh, what a great pass there from BJ Holmes. Inside to Mike Tuck, who lays it up.
Yeah, so that basket came because Mike Tuck set a really good screen and Watson got hung up, which forced a switch. And BJ got it to Tuck for an easy layup, but that's just too easy down the middle from Sheffield defensive point of view.
Strong drive there from Bernardini. And he made that look easy with a strong drive to basket. Mike Cook now goes in, looks to dish it off. And Bernardini puts the ball out, but the referees want to talk about that one. Not too much complaint from the Sharks, so probably did come off one of them.
Yeah, it was pretty easy to see from here, and I think the key thing there, Atiba Lai stood about 5 feet away, didn't even say anything.
Riders moving the ball well, looking to get it inside and do. But a good hand from Mike Tuck there. Stops the shot going up as Mike Cook drives down the middle. Great block there from Trevon Wright, rises way up. Bernardini there, good D from Mike Tuck, holds him up, stops him. As John Barber steps around and pulls the ball in, gets the steal. Quick down the court, and Mike Tuck with the spin, lays it in. Great period of play there from the Sharks.
Yeah, so Mike Cook attacks the basket. Trevon Wright, probably the most athletic player in the league, he raised his layup, but Sheffield with a great steal, and Mike Tuck doing what he does, running the floor hard. Had a mismatch and made a good move.
Oh, great D again from the Sharks there. The help comes in. But not enough. And Mike Cook there, just a little misunderstanding with Zach Gachet there, and Sharks just making to make that work better and get on with the game now and just make up for that. But playing well at the moment, both teams.
Yeah, well, a few turnovers though, but you can see the intensity is definitely up from when we were here the other day. You know, Sheffield just need to, we talked earlier on, just take care of the ball. I mean, that turnover, you don't want it, but at least the ball went out of bounds. You know, so Leicester aren't just running it back down their throat.
She gives the ball back to the Sharks, so we're coming up 5 minutes 40 seconds, got in the first quarter, and the Sharks down by one, and it's really tight, intense game as Mike Cook drives, comes off the screen, and Mike Tuck looks to hit the three, goes in and out, doesn't get the drop, and the Riders pull the ball in and come down the floor. Watson looking to maybe try and get the ball inside, but it gets reversed. Anthony Rose in the game for the Riders, kicks it to Watson. Tyler now goes hard. Bernardini takes a great drive and pulls up in the middle, and he's been a spark for the Riders all season and has certainly been one of the key players in Sharks Riders matchup so far this season.
Yeah, he's played really well for a first year player in this league. Started off the season really, really well, then had an injury and was quiet for 2 or 3 months, but has finished it really strong. Been, you know, their key player probably down the stretch as they tried to get back into the league race with Newcastle, ultimately just fell a little bit short.
PJ Holmes in the corner with the ball there, going up against Anderson, finds John Barber, who rearranges around the arm and lays it in. Back to a 1-point lead for the Riders.
Yeah, so good concentration by Barber. Looked like he was going to throw it down and pulled out at the last second and made a nice shot with his left hand.
Anderson steps out in the corner there, hits a three.
So Anderson's shooting 40% from the three. If you think where he was even a year ago, you know, not a renowned shooter, but now you have to guard him. I know Rob Paternoster really, really pleased with how he's progressed and probably, you know, in Paternoster's words, his MVP this year for the Leicester team.
Mike Cook there makes a nice drive to the basket, comes off the curl, a good pass from Zach Gachet. Washington drives to the middle, kicks it across out to Wright, who shoots the three, doesn't get the drop, and the Sharks pull the ball in. A chance to go down the court. Mike Cook drives to the middle, kicks it out wide to Zach Gachet, who hits a three for down the side, and the Sharks lead for the first time in the game by one. A long way to go, but John Barber gets a hand on the ball, and it comes up in Mike Cook's hands, who lays it in. And all of a sudden it's a 3-point lead. In no time at all, the Sharks have gone from down to up. A long way to go in the game, but really, really impressed with how the Sharks have started this game. Just need to tidy up on the turnovers, Andrew.
Now I think Barber's got his hands on like three or four passes. They've been really active in the passing lane. You know, Sheffield, they need to try and keep this momentum going. You know, it'd be difficult for the whole game, but you know, they've set the standard now.
Anderson there makes a good move inside. Brings the little Sharks run to the end. As BJ Holmes does the pick and roll with Mike Tuck, who goes a little long on that shot, doesn't get anything, and the Riders pull the ball in and come down the floor. Zach Gachet looking to screen from Rowe. Mike Tuck reaches in there.
Yeah, easy call for the ref, you know. Look, we were pretty close and looked like you're going right across the middle of the chest.
Lasonski with the ball, finds Washington, runs BJ Holmes off the screen, and the Sharks nearly get a hand to that, but Rowe does, but there's a whistle there. Didn't quite see that, but too much complaint from Nick Lewis. Must have gambled on that to try and get a hand on it and caught the player.
Yeah, he went for the steal, caught him right across the arm and a little bit with the body. And, you know, once Leicester didn't have clean possession, it was an easy call for the ref.
Washington goes round the screen and pulls up. Revite gets the ball, but Pat Horseman comes from behind and rejects that. And the Sharks regrouping on defence, trying to make sure, but Washington, smart move there, just steps back away from all the big guys in the middle, creates some space and takes an easy jump shot to give the Riders the lead again with 2 minutes to go in the first quarter, 16-15. BJ Holmes comes off the dribble, pulls up, knocks it down, and that's an easy look for BJ Holmes.
Yeah, needs to be aggressive, has been successful early in games being aggressive. Something he needs to do and keep up for the rest of the game.
The Riders move the ball around, but misses, and the Sharks come up with the ball. And Nick Lewis with the fake drives to the middle and takes a little floater layup. The Sharks lead by three now. The Riders now set up a play. Roll there, pretty static, looking to try and get the ball inside. Shot clock running down now for the Riders. Bernardini feeds it into Lasonski. The double team's there. A whistle called. Foul is called on BJ Holmes. Ball gets kicked to the corner and out to Anderson and reverse to Washington. Great ball movement there from the Riders. And a hand on from Anthony Rowe gives the ball back to them. Anderson from the opposite side doesn't get it. And this time, Mike Tuck pulls the ball. Another whistle for another off the ball foul there. Some experienced height into his team. Ball comes in. Nick Lewis goes down the floor. Finds BJ Holmes, who comes off the screen. Tries to get the pick and roll to Mike Tuck. Doesn't quite pull it in. And Washington lays it in for two. Pat Horseman from the top, hits the, takes the shot. Another foul called off the ball by, on the Riders, Barry Lammel for holding under the basket, just like you said earlier from Rowe, Andrew.
So Leicester in the zone here, trying to take anything away from the corner. Good job by Sheffield attacking the middle.
Mike Tuck attacks the ring there, doesn't get the basket. And the Riders should get the last shot of the quarter. Watson feeds it into Lamble, who shoots from close distance. Doesn't get the drop. And at the end of the first, the Sharks leading 19-18. So after one quarter of basketball, there's only one point in it here at EIS Sheffield between the Sharks and the Riders in the playoff quarter-final first leg. And Andrew, the first quarter, just as you said, could be tight. Looking for one of these teams looking to try and be a little bit more consistent, maybe put a run on.
Yes, right now it's more a Sheffield kind of tempo, the way the game's been played. Arguably they could have had a tiny bit bigger lead if they made a couple of layups and not had a couple of silly turnovers. So, you know, Leicester needs to come out and, from their point of view, make something happen. And I think that means for them increasing the tempo of the game.
And they're exchanged the baskets between the Riders and the Sharks, and Alu Babalola found himself matched up against the small Connor White as Lasonski gets to the middle. And the Sharks get the ball there as Lasonski tips it out of bounds. And the Riders bring Bernardini back in.
There we go, looks like they're going to press. Some kind of zone press here from Leicester. Just to change the tempo of the game more than anything.
Patrick Horseman there dribbles the ball over the half. Gets it in. Uses up some of the clock for the Sharks. And John Barber finds himself down the middle. Kicks it out and the ball's reversed to Nick Lewis, who drives and lays it in off the glass. Great patient basketball there from the Sharks. Alu Babalola nearly gets a hand on it there. Ball being moved around well by the Riders at the moment. They've certainly got some looking to move the ball and set a play here. Ball goes inside. Lasonski goes up against that, but it gets kicked out. The ball's moved. Trevon Wright goes in. And Bernardini Tyler from the corner doesn't get a drop. A little bit rushed at the end for the Riders, so some good defence there from the Sharks.
Yeah, Leicester never really got the ball moving from side to side, so the defence didn't shift.
Mike Cook with the ball now, looking to set something up. Goes against Lasonski, a great outlet. Good outlet from the Riders there, and a hard foul by Patrick Horseman. No easy baskets in playoff basketball. Bernardini Tyler steps up. Misses the second, so good foul from Patrick there. Mate. Only allowed the Riders to get 1 point. As Nick Lewis drives baseline looking to get the ball.
Too much dribble. Sheffield don't need to get into the game where there's too much dribble.
What a great move there from the Sharks. And it just looks like John Barber's gone down on the floor and looks like he's struggling. There's a travel call there on the Riders. Alu Babalola there brings the ball up the floor for the Sharks and trying to get the ball into one of the guards' hands. Mike Cook gets it. Setting up a screen there. Uses that screen. Feeds it inside to Mike Cook, who gets his man up in the air and lays it in. Tough basket. Great pick and roll and a great finish from Mike Cook. And the Riders come down the floor looking to respond.
Good patience by Tuck to take his time. A couple of head fakes and then got in there.
No basket there, not given. Foul on Mike Cook. Anderson has the ball. Quick movement. And Bernardini from the corner hits a three. Brings the Riders back to within three. So the Sharks did have a 6 point lead. It's a great job by the Sharks so far in this game. Alu Babalola gets Trevon Wright up in the air and draws the contact there. Soft foul for Wright, really, but great move by Alu, just gets the team in foul trouble.
Yeah, great job by Alu, but I think Paternostra will not be happy with that. You know, you don't need to lose a foul on Olu Babalola in that situation.
Olu Babalola with a great vision, just dishes it off inside to Mike Took, gives him the easy look inside.
Yes.
And the Sharks lead by five.
So Leicester's initial defence is okay, but then after their first rotation, it's not great. They're not getting the helper situation, and Sheffield making an extra pass, and it's really working for them on the offensive end.
Siobhan right there hits the three, keeps the scoreboard ticking over in both teams. It's a tight game here at EIS Sheffield so far. Nick Lewis trying to get the ball in, and Watson there hustling hard, tries to get the steal. Nick Lewis drives, gets the glass up there. Bernardini there comes off two screens on the baseline, and the Sharks pull that in and really working Bernardini hard. He likes to come off those screens, Andrew, and curl them with the ball in his hands to shoot.
Yeah, that was a wide open shot. He'll be disappointed he missed it, but that wasn't great defense by Sheffield. They just got away with Bernardini missing the shot. Lewis got caught up. Oh,
wow. Javon Wright takes off there.
That's just insane athleticism. Kind of reminds me of when I played a little bit, but I wish.
There's a few people that will work hard to remember that from you, Andrew. But certainly a great basket from Trevon right there, which leads to a timeout, and the score's tied at 29. Tim bound the ball. Mike Cook now at the point, trying to make sure Sharks get something. And BJ Holmes comes off the curl, doesn't make the jump shot there. A good look out of the timeout for the Sharks as the Riders come down the floor. And Trevon Wright, who just took off. Oh, and Sharks leave Watson open there, who just steps in and hits a three. And the Riders lead by three now. Game is tight game. Both teams working hard. The scoreboard ticking over as Mike Cook shoots a three, doesn't get it to drop. Coming up to 4 minutes left to play here in the first half, and Hassan with the ball. Watson from out there again hits another three, and this time Mike Cook pulls the ball in, a box out from Mike Took. Mike Took drives against Anderson, gets the foul as they're looking to try and get the ball inside to Mike Took. That happens, and he kicks it out to Patrick, who looks to dribble it but turns back. What a move by Mike Took there. Gets a big contact inside there from Hassan, and sends Mike Took to the line for two shots. Mike Took makes just one there and brings it back to a two-point lead for the Riders. 3.5 minutes left in the first half, and the Riders on top at the moment. But the Sharks working hard, trying to get back into the, making sure they're in this game. Pass over the top there, finds Trevon Wright from way out. And Mike Took with a hand in his face, and he still makes it. Tough basket there from Trevon Wright. Great quick move there by Mike Took there, just caught the guy off guard, Andrew, I think.
Yeah, Lasonski did a great job pushing Took out, and once he pushed him out of that far, he just needed to give him a little bit of space, because, you know, in the sky, but Took doesn't really shoot that little in-between shot from 6 to 8 feet. So if you give him a little bit of space when he does, because he likes to go quick, just eliminates you from a personal point of view getting that foul.
Patrick Horseman there takes a quick turnaround shot off the inbound, but Mike Cook makes the steal, who lays it, who dunks it. The old dog's got him up there, and he dunks it. ties the goal. Sorry, it brings the Sharks back to within three, 32-35.
So just a sneaky little quick dunk there from Cook. Just dropped the ball in. So good job by Sheffield. Sheffield need an easy basket.
Watson goes baseline, but the help comes. But a good job by the Riders who move the ball around. And the ball comes up in the Sharks' hands. And Zachary Shetz going down, who tries to feed it through to Pat Horseman. But a great steal by the Riders. And they come back down the other end. And Trevon Wright takes off and jams it home.
Yeah, so there's Taylor in 3 seconds, two decisions. You know, Gachet made a poor one, and Watson had it down this end, looking to throw the alley-oop, but thought better of it and got it to Wright for an easy layup.
Pat Horseman goes baseline, kicks it out again, and it's in Mike Cook's hands as he goes down the middle. Great drive straight down the middle and lays it in. Keeps it to a three-point game. The Sharks trying to step out on the defense. Keep Lisonski. Oh, great crossover. Goes up against Mike. Zach Gachet goes up high, but good defense from Tyler Bernardini, who kicks it out to Zach Gachet, who shoots the three. Doesn't get it to drop, and good boxing out there from Watson means the Riders get the ball. Another fast break this time. Can the Sharks get anything? A lot of contact there on that layup from Mike Tuck, but nothing given by the referees, and Coach Lyon's not happy about that. Certainly talking to the referee. But a good period of play for the Sharks brings them back to within one. Timeout from the Riders, leading 37-36. So out of the timeout, the Sharks down by one. 50 seconds left in this first half. Riders with the ball. John Barber's back in the game. An offensive foul called again.
Pretty easy call for the ref. Everybody moving at speed, and Lisonski wasn't set, and he just stepped across him.
Easy defense for the Sharks there when the offensive team helps you out. So the Sharks get the ball back. Chance to maybe go into the lead here. Sharks looking to get the ball inside. Find Mike Tuck finds Mike Cook, and we do get that, the lead there. Little jump shot from just above the free-throw line. Sharks lead by one. I just love to know how many times the lead's changed so far in this game, Andrew. It's been a really tight contest. Both teams having good little spells.
Yeah, Leicester pushed out a little bit, but Sheffield have pulled it right back. Leicester got a bit of a mismatch here. Good foul by Horseman because Sheffield aren't in the penalty.
Riders get the ball in and kick it to Trevon Wright, who's just hit two but doesn't get it. Mike Cook thinks about throwing it from there. Full court here at the end of the half, and the Sharks lead by one at the end of the first, 38-37. Here we are at the start of the second half. Playoff action here at EIS Sheffield. The Sharks versus the Riders. Second versus seventh. Currently the Sharks leading by one, 38-37. BJ Holmes goes down the middle. Takes a little rearranged jump shot. Reverses it, and the Sharks come up with a rebound thanks to, as BJ Holmes goes in and lays it off the glass.
Yeah, that was a good finish by BJ. Trevon Wright came across and he flicked it up really high on the glass, nice and soft, and it dropped through for him.
And it's been a really intense first half, Andrew. We're hoping more in a second, but who stood out for you so far in this game?
I think, you know, for Sheffield, a few guys have been effective. Cook's got to the basket well.
Whoa.
Mike Tuck's been, you know, effective inside, worked hard, a few nice moves. I think BJ Holmes needs to be, he's going to probably be Sheffield's key player in this second half. You know, pretty quiet compared to recent games. Let's hope he can explode in the second half.
Mike Tuck crosses over, steps back, knocks down the two, gives the Sharks the lead again after Watson took a big three at the end of the shot clock just before to tie the game. And as you say, Andrew, lots of players playing well so far in this game. And here's the guy that's really taken off in this game a few times. High-flying dunks, Trevon Wright. Bernardini Tyler, Mike Cook gets a hand on that, knocks it out of bounds and chews up some more clock. 5 seconds left on the shot clock now for the Riders. Need to get that ball inbound and get a good shot straight away. Plenty of time to do that, but also time for the Sharks to put some pressure on. Bernardini kicks it to Watson in the corner, who hits it up and takes another shot, doesn't make it this time. And Mike Cook comes down with the ball, who crosses over and goes to the middle, steps back, knocks it down. Beautiful step back move there from Mike Cook. Watson feeds it in, a hand in there, referee calls a whistle on John Barber, who reaches in, gets the foul call. Hassan makes one from two. Sharks pull the rebound in with Mike Tuck, and Zach Rochette brings the ball up the floor. BJ Holmes feeds it through to John Barber. Zach Rochette gets the ball and he just steps up at the top. Doesn't get the ball to drop. Watson comes down with the ball and Tyler drives hard to the middle, but BJ Holmes gets a hand and it's a quick layup at the other end for the Sharks. Hassan goes up against Mike Tuck, moves it around. Watson again feeds it back into the post and it's Tyler with a hard drive, but the help comes, but Trevon's out. Trevon Wright's out there and John Barber pulls the big rebound in with Anderson trying to steal it off him over the back. And Mike Cook gets to the middle, lays it up, puts it in. It's a 7-point lead for the Sharks, but it's a quick move down and right there makes a rearrange but doesn't get it to drop, and it's fast flowing here at EIS Sheffield. The Sharks with the ball again in BJ Holmes' hands. He's shouting, he wants to try and get this ball back inside. John Barber throws the flick, makes a layup. That's enough for Coach Paternoster, who didn't want his team to come out and start like that. The Sharks leading by nine. And Andrew, great start from the Sharks, exactly what Coach Lyons would have wanted.
Yeah, great start to the half by Sheffield. And what you notice is all their shots are layups at the basket. That's a real concerted effort to attack. Leicester going for every pump fake going, which I'm not sure is the best strategy, but playing into Sheffield's hands at the moment. Down the other end, Leicester a bit out of sync as to what they want to do on the offensive end. So I'm sure, you know, that's, you know, one of the things Rob Paternoster will be talking about in this timeout is called.
So as we come back out of the timeout, the Sharks lead by 9, 50-41. Watson brings the ball up for the Riders out of timeout. The double team comes. The Sharks put a lot of pressure there. The clock counting down, but they find Watson, who throws the fake, sets his feet and breaks the Sharks' run by hitting a good look three there.
Watson shot the three well tonight. Sheffield obviously trying to run him off the line. He's been patient, thrown a couple of head fakes and made the shots after that. Not the easiest shots to make.
Zach Gachette there drives to the middle. Doesn't get it to drop. And the dangerous Watson with the ball is going against Mike Tuck and gets the steal, and the Riders hustle there, brings the ball back in and they come up with the ball, and Watson hits a big three, and since the timeout has really hurt the Sharks with two threes, brings it back to a 3-point game.
Yeah, Sheffield made a mistake there. They got the steal, the turnover, they went for the home run play, turned it over, and Watson with another big three.
Great pass from Mike Cook there to Mike Tuck. Really should have made that layup. Sealed his man really well, but didn't get it to drop, and the Riders come down with the ball. And that great start from the Sharks just being taken away by the Riders. Lasonski goes against Mike Tuck, gets nowhere, but finds it opposite to Washington. Good defence by John Barber. Hassan gets the ball up. And Mike Cook gets the rebound and it gets back in his hand and he gets down the middle. Zach Gachet in the post there, going up against Watson. Finds Mike Tuck underneath, who lays it in. And the Sharks end that mini run by the Riders. It's all tight here at EIS Sheffield in playoff basketball. Both teams making sure they make something out of this. Lasonski there rearranges everything, doesn't get it to drop, but does get it rearranged. It's tapped in by Hassan. And the athletic Hassan rises high there to pull the ball in as Mike Cook goes down the middle and lays it in. And Connor Washington there steps in, doesn't inbound the ball. The referee spots that and it's a turnover.
Yeah, Sheffield just need to keep the tempo of the game where it is, keep playing aggressive. And, you know, Leicester, oh.
Lasonski kicks the ball, gets a steal, kicks it out, and Watson misses that one, which is unusual tonight because he shot really well from out in three-point range. But Olu Babalola pulls the rebound in. BJ Holmes there finds Olu Babalola, who's against the small Watson there, and uses his body well to make sure he creates the space for the layup.
Leicester switching a lot of screens. They've been caught out a few times tonight.
Lasonski there rearranges and gets the drop. The Sharks leading by five. 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. And this intense basketball game. Bernardino Tyler gets moved off as Mike Cook creates some space. And the ball comes off Lasonski and goes out of bounds. And Mike Tuck there, Little gets it in, and Nick Lewis back in the corner, but ball comes back around. BJ Holmes from deep, doesn't get the drop, and it comes off Patrick Horseman. Mike Tuck there trying to get a hand onto it. Rose sets a big screen there on BJ Holmes, fights his way around it, and the Riders definitely looking, trying to get the ball inside, but in Watson's hands the ball's good, but the Sharks come up with that. Olu Babalola there looking to try and get the ball inside. Sharks trying to get the ball movement. Nick Lewis spins baseline, goes up against the body and lays it in. Great move by Nick Lewis there to the basket.
Took his time, attacked off the pump fake. Nice spin move, good concentration to finish the layup.
And we got a great game of basketball here, Andrew. You know, one of those that you would have loved to play in, I think, where the intensity is really high and both teams going hard at each other.
It's easy, when you're a player, it's easy to play in games like this. You know it means something. Great defense by Sheffield. And these are the games it's easy to get up for. When you're playing against teams that aren't so good, it's not such a big situation. They're the games that sometimes as a player, yeah, that you struggle with.
And the intensity there just showing a little bit. The Riders not aware the shot clock was counting down, and the Sharks get the shot clock violation. Chance to try and stretch their lead here, leading by seven with a minute and a half left in the third quarter. Patrick Horseman spins, goes up, doesn't get a drop. The high flying Trevon Wright pulls it in, and Connor Washington there dribbles down, pulls up, wants to set the offense. Bernardini there looking to try and pass the ball over BJ, but doesn't go inside. Has it back now, still looking to feed it inside. The clock's counting down, but Wright goes to the middle, takes off and lays it off the glass. And he is one athletic player, Andrew.
Two plays in a row there. Massive offensive defensive rebound just off athleticism. And there, shot clock winding down.
DJ Holmes throws the fake. DJ Holmes there from the corner. And Trevon Wright there holding Mike Tuck. Mike Tuck's been worrying it out under the boards tonight. He's had two or three calls called on it for him. But Ryder's players holding him. Stretch our lead maybe going into half time. Ball's getting moved around. BJ Holmes gets to the middle, pulls up, doesn't get it to drop. And the Riders pull the ball in and have a chance to score. Looking to attack the basket. Probably will hold till the end of the shot clock to try and make sure the Sharks don't get another chance to score. Bernardini trying to feed in, gets it to Hassan. But BJ Holmes gets a steal. And he's going up against and looks to rearrange. Gets it to drop. But the Riders get the ball and it's with Trevon Wright, who pulls up. But Ola Babalola gets a hand on it. And the Sharks come out at the end of the third quarter, leading by seven. A great quarter for the Sharks, Andrew.
Did all their damage attacking the basket. Can't remember them making a jump shot, you know, from outside. Maybe Cook's pull-up jump shot from about 10 feet. Everything else at the basket. Which does a couple of things. It puts pressure on Leicester's defense, but it, you know, stops them getting out in transition if Sheffield do miss, because the rebounds inevitably land around the basket. So they've done a good job not turning it over, containing Leicester. Hopefully they can do that in the fourth quarter and keep this momentum up.
So as we come out of the, into the fourth quarter, the Sharks leading by 7, 60-53. So here we are at the top of the fourth quarter. The Sharks leading by 7. It's been a great game. It'll definitely not be. It'll be closer than this, I think, Andrew, as we go through this quarter. The Riders certainly not going to give up. They're going to want to try and take a lead back to Leicester for the second leg. As Hassan goes to the middle, kicks it across to Watson, who's made some big shots. And the Sharks come up with the ball. Another defensive stop for the Sharks. Can they punish the Riders here? Kicking inside to Pat Horseman, who doesn't get the drop. And maybe the chance there to punish them wasn't lost, but more defense required from the Sharks. Bernardini's been kept quiet in this game. Really, really had some big quarters against the Sharks. And the ball comes off Bernardini, goes out of bounds. And everybody thinks that's a Sharks. Certainly all the Riders fans think there was a foul there, but nobody else has said that. And the Sharks come up with the ball. Two defensive stops. Really need to make the Riders pay for that. As Nick Lewis looks to go down the middle.
Leicester doing a really poor job looking after the ball. Generally a team that takes care of it pretty well. Watson usually makes good decisions. So from their side, that's what they need to clean up. But from Sheffield, you know, that's what's fueling them and getting them this lead. That pressure, creating layups at the other end.
Nick Lewis there going in against that. But Trevon Wright there steps up with the long arms and makes the stop. Oh. And Trevon Wright, the big step around Mike Tuck. Back to a 5-point game.
Great Euro step by Wright. Probably the move that's come into the game a lot the last 2 to 3 years.
Ola Babalola goes around everybody there. And the Watson comes down the floor. And Wright takes off. And he's played above the rim a lot of the game. And there's another example of it, Andrew.
When you have a player like that and you're out in the break, 3-on-1 to Leicester there, just throw it anywhere near the rim. Defender's got no chance. And even if he did try and do anything, it'd be a really frowned upon foul. Nothing you can do. Great execution by Leicester, and we're back to a 3-point game.
So we've come out of timeouts. The Sharks lead by 3, 60-57. Nick Lewis brings the ball up for the Sharks as they come out of the timeout. The Sharks looking to end that run. Mike Cook's back in the game. BJ Holmes goes to rearrange. Mike Tuck there makes some, clears some bodies out of the way. But doesn't come up with the ball. And chance for the Riders now to keep eating into that Sharks lead. Good ball movement from the Riders. Anderson comes down, ball's loose. Who did he come off last? And he comes up with a Riders ball. Must have come off Mike Cook slightly there, went out of bounds. And the Riders get 14 seconds on.
I think it was a kick ball. I think they're saying it came off Mike Cook's foot.
Bernardini there, tough basket off the glass. So 1 point lead to the Sharks. And Sharks needing to make sure they can turn up the offense against this Riders defense. They did it in the third quarter, Andrew, going to the basket. Azola Babalola crosses over, goes up against Trevon Wright, and a whistle there. Reached in.
Good job by Sheffield, staying with attacking the basket. Probably didn't get into the offense how they wanted to, but Ollie did a good job attacking the basket. Leicester's defensive intensity, though, has really picked up this last since that timeout. You know, Paternoster obviously wasn't happy, got into them, and they've been a bit step closer to their man, a little bit more aggressive, and forced two stops before that foul.
Babalola makes them both, ends that run from the Riders, and the ball comes in and the Sharks lead by three, 62-59, 7.5 to go here in the game. Big screen from Hassan finds BJ Holmes, and they come up with the ball, the Sharks, and good hustle by Mike Tuck, pulls the ball in. Nick Lewis there holds up, resets the play of the ball with BJ, who's looking to get Mike Tuck in. Ball comes off, a little bit scrappy in there. And the Riders come up with the ball. Big screen there, another offensive foul by the Riders. An easy call there for the referees to make, and a moving screen coming in. The Sharks get the ball out to Nick Lewis, who goes through the middle, tries to rearrange, doesn't get anything there, gets it knocked away. Anderson comes down the middle, hits Watson, who drives to the middle, is going to pull up there, but doesn't get anything. Mike Cook there crosses over. Gets the ball in. Mike Cook took there, tough offensive play. In fact, the body comes in there. Mike Cook steps back and hits the step back. Back out to five for the Sharks. And when the Sharks needed a basket, Mike Cook stepped up, Andrew.
Yeah, that was a tough shot. Took a really big step back to create the space and made it. Good shot by Bernardini, going left, nice pull up. Created a lot of space on a straight pull-up and made a nice shot.
So Nick Lewis trying to get the ball in. What a move by Mike Tuck. He's dominated underneath the boards tonight. He's really worked physically hard.
Yeah, he's making really quick moves, and Hassan can't really do anything with him tonight. Yeah, good job by Tuck, you know, keeping the pressure on and attacking.
Mike Tuck makes two from two. And Job Barber comes back into the game. And Mike Tuck goes out, probably just for a breather, Andrew. Make sure he can come back in to close out the game fresh.
Yeah, this will be a really short rest. Obviously tired, asking to come out.
The Sharks there, great defense. And the Sharks get the ball, it comes off Watson's foot in there. And the Sharks get the ball. And at the moment, Andrew, not wishing to speak too soon, but the Sharks putting themselves in a good position in this first leg.
Yeah, there's only 5.5 minutes left, and the Sheffield are smart. You know, no matter how this 5 minutes goes, they're going to give themselves a chance on Friday.
Mike Cook steps underneath, lays it in, back out to 7 points for the Sharks. And Bernardini there switching the ball. A player the Sharks need to keep quiet, can score in bunches, Bernardini, just like Mike Cook. But the Sharks did a good job on him tonight. Lisonski goes against John Barber, who pulls the rebound in. Good defence from John Barber, who looks like he's struggling on that ankle that he hurt earlier. But what, making playing tough out there. John Barber crosses the ball over behind, kicks it out to Pat Horsman in the corner. Oh, hits the three! And the Sharks lead by 10. 71-61, 4:36 left. And the Riders want a timeout to talk it over. So with 4 minutes 30 left here in the first leg of the quarter-final of the playoffs, Sharks are leading by 10. We're coming out of the Riders' timeout. Oh, Trevon Wright. Turns and Pat Horsman reaches in with the foul. And
yeah, Sheffield can really attack this last 4 minutes of the game. Expect them to... Oh, it would be smart for them to throw it inside, because, you know, if you do that, the chance of drawing fouls takes out long rebounds that might fuel Leicester breaks to get back in the game.
Sharks get the ball in safely. Wright makes both those, brings it back to 8 points. Mike Cook there uses the screen. He's trying to feed. Thinks he didn't travel, but the referees have called it. Gives the ball back to the Riders.
Yeah, he went from almost on the three-point line to inside the free throw line without dribbling. I mean, even if it's not, it looks like it is, you know, and the refs are going to call it.
The Sharks switching a little bit here. Watson crosses over. The Sharks use that. Bernardini shoots from way out. But the Riders come up with the ball, find Watson, up on the three, doesn't make that one, and the Sharks pull the ball in and head back down the floor. Mike Tuck looking to maybe take control, lays it in, and gets called for the foul, charge taken. Looked like a good move, Andrew, but just caught the player, took good position.
Yeah, Bernardini was there off the switch. I mean, everything was moving really quick. Could have gone either way. But, you know, sometimes it's nice to see the refs rewarding good defence.
Good defence from Olu Babalola. Both Mike Tuck and Lisonski there. Hustling hard. No real complaint from Mike Tuck, just saying, was that fair? But both players just really boxing out hard, trying to make sure the ball, and good job from Mike Tuck there, make sure the ball comes back to the Sharks. Goes out of bounds off Leicester. And with 3 minutes to go here in the game, the Sharks leading by 8. Olu Babalola trying to get the ball inside again to Mike Tuck, who draws another foul. Inside. And all night long, Andrew, Mike Tuck has took care of business in the paint.
Ball really hard for position. Established it there, Lisonski caught pushing, two hands in the back. Something the refs have been consistent on all year.
Interestingly, that brings back in Hassan, who's on 4 fouls. So another body for Mike Tuck to go after, Andrew.
I mean, to be fair, Hassan or Lisonski haven't had their greatest games tonight. I think they'd be the first to admit that, so I wouldn't be, you know, that concerned about it if I was Sheffield.
Mike Tuck makes one from two. Sharks lead by nine. Riders come down the floor. Watson nearly loses the dribble, but Sharks pull it in as Washington skips through. But the Sharks nearly come up with the ball again. The shot clock's counting down. Trevon Wright steps out to three-point range. Doesn't get it. And it comes off the Sharks, but the Sharks hustling hard, trying to get that ball back in. A couple of chances to get a steal there, but still nearly come up with the ball, and the defence is working hard for both teams.
Yeah, both teams have played pretty well on defence. Obviously, it's the playoffs. You've got more time to scout and prepare.
Watson shoots over the top of BJ Holmes there. Big three-point play. Brings it back to 6 points to the Sharks with the ball, coming up to 2 minutes to go here as BJ Holmes finds Mike Cook curling off the middle, and he goes down the middle and the foul is called. Mike Cook misses both of those. To find Watson. A foul there, just Mike caught Mike Cook's foot. Sorry, Mike Tuck's foot. It's 2 minutes here to go here in the fourth quarter. The Riders making a run to come back into the game, and Washington goes baseline. Doesn't get there, but Mike Tuck does pull the ball in. But Bernardini reaches in from behind. And Coach Paternostra not happy because his team's in foul trouble, and that's points to the Sharks to help stretch out the lead. Mike Cook makes two from two. And the Sharks defense stepping out there. And Mike Cook there called for the foul. Probably just tried to step out too hard against over that screen and just caught Washington as he came through. Washington with the ball. Kicks it to Anderson, who turns, tries to get the layup, and the Sharks come up with the ball. And Coach Paternostra shouting to his team, don't foul, don't foul. Just as you said, Andrew, we don't need to give the Sharks a bigger lead. As John Barber goes down the middle, and there's a foul. Mike Cook has the ball in his hands. All these shots count now. Mike Cook giving a second chance because Watson had gone inside the three-point line. Makes that one. And a technical foul call now against Coach Paternostra. A chance now for the Sharks. I think he was just trying to ask why did he get another chance, but referee saying that was too much, calling for a technical. Mike Cook hits those two, and the one for the technical foul brings it an 11-point lead for the Sharks with just over a minute to go. And Andrew, if the Sharks can stretch this anymore, this starts to become significant.
I think, you know, Leicester not be, you know, too distraught with it, but it's certainly a nice advantage for Sheffield going down there. Leicester, they've not shown their full hand yet tonight. They've not really pressed at all. Expect to see a lot of that on Friday to change the game. So it'll be interesting to see how Sheffield handle that on Friday, but they're certainly putting themselves in a good position.
Mike Cook steps back, makes a big shot there. And the riders come down the floor, and Olu Babalola nearly gets a steal, but it comes off his leg there. And the Sharks leading by 13. The riders get a ball into Bernardini, who goes down, doesn't get the drop. And they kick it out, and Watson is up there, hits the three, takes it. And there's a foul there, Olu Babalola gets the foul called on Trevon Wright, who flew up there to get that rebound.
So Sheffield just need to manage it so they get the last shot. Got to make sure you box out here. If Leicester miss, Sheffield have to get the rebound.
We might. So the Sharks call for a timeout as Trevon Knight makes them both. The Sharks leading by 11, 79-68. The Sharks with the ball, trying to get it in. And they managed to do that to Mike Cook, who will have a chance here. Mike Cook there goes on the dribble, pulls up, doesn't get anything there, that's not a good look. And Bernardini comes down, dribbles the ball off his foot, and Olu Babalola gets it, puts the ball up. And Mike Cook pulls in the last rebound. And the Sharks win this one 79-68. And Andrew, you picked Mike Cook for the MVP tonight. A real warrior performance, took care of the paint all night long.
He did, obviously 20 points and the rebounds we see, but the thing for me was the 8 fouls he drew. You know, effectively took two of Leicester's big guys out of the game, had Sheffield in the bonus, allowed them to dictate the tempo of the game, keep it down. It meant Leicester couldn't get in transition. Mike Cook played well, he made a lot of big shots, but for me, Tug just shaded it because of that.
Well, here we are, 11-point lead in the second quarter, for the second playoff, sorry, away at Leicester. There's a long way to go in this one, but the Sharks at the moment have the upper hand.
Hi, Mike, excellent game tonight. You dominated inside the play. Can you just take us through that?
Yeah, I mean, Leicester's, you know, a really good team, you know, second in the league, so we knew we had to come out, be very aggressive tonight, and you know, take care of business in the paint. I think that was the key to the win tonight, was being aggressive inside. You know, me and Mike Cook especially drew some fouls. You know, I think I got a lot of fouls inside and got their big men in foul trouble. So really helped us throughout the game. We got to the free throw line, knocked down free throws, and gives us a comfortable lead going into the second half.
Obviously, also you managed to pull out those fouls, which really helped going into the next game.
Yeah. I mean, you know, Hassan, early foul trouble, which, you know, opened it up for me a little bit inside in the paint. And now we have a comfortable lead. I think the main thing now is, you know, keeping our focus and staying ready for Friday.
Obviously, the points transition over to Friday's game. How do you hope to keep momentum up running into that game?
You know, away games, you know, we're off our home territory, so it's just mentally, you know, gearing up and getting ready to go down there. And it's going to be a hell of a match down there. I think for us, we have to prepare. We can't think that we have a 10-point lead, but more like go in there that we're down 10.
Congratulations on MVP tonight, Mike. Cheers. Congratulations on the win today, Atiba. What was your plan coming into the game, and how did it develop throughout?
Well, I think it was kind of fortuitous that we played them a couple weeks ago, so we kind of refreshed our minds as far as the players and what they like to do and individual players. We just came out and just said we had to match their intensity. It's a very intense team. They play at a high speed, and they're very aggressive as far as just cutting and moving without the ball, and they can really cause confusion. So we just had to make sure we rotated the right way and played at that kind of high energy level for the 40 minutes.
Great. And for the next game, obviously the points carry over. How are you going to keep momentum up and keep us where we are today?
We just have to try to, you know, you can't really play any other way than trying to win. You can't play not to lose. You got to just go out there and you got to execute. You got to play hard. You got to do the same things. You know, 11 points seems like a lot, but it's really in four possessions. You know, they get hot and they can turn that around in the first couple minutes. So it's about just controlling the tempo and quality possessions on offense for us.
Great, great. Thanks, Atiba. A great game here at the AIS Sheffield with the Sharks winning 79-68. Of course, the game doesn't quite end here as we have the game away at Leicester and the points continue. If the Sharks do win that game, we will then have another one at home, which you can find highlights of on Sheffield Live TV a few days after it happens. If you want to watch any of the previous games or the game tonight again, feel free to watch it on our YouTube channel, Sheffield Sharks. From all of us here at Sheffield Sharks TV, we'd like to say good night and thank you for watching.